Joy and I want you to tune into today's episode as we interview this real estate agent, and he's going to share how he went from the hospitality industry to being an absolute rock star in real estate and what he did to go from $7 million in volume to $11 million in volume in a short 2 years. Don't miss this one. What's up, everybody, and welcome to the Justin Ford Podcast, where I'll be releasing life-changing principles and valuable information focused on all things faith, finance, family, fitness, real estate, and so much more. Let's go! What's up, everybody? Super excited to be here with you again on another episode. And yes, we were just playing paper, rock, scissors with our guest today.
I totally won, by the way.
Super excited to be with you guys. And it is, already the end of January, and this month is already flying by. I'm super excited for this episode. I've got Joy Ford in the house.
Hello.
And we've got our amazing guest, Eric Levanduski.
Yes, pronounced correctly.
From Remax Bayshore in Traverse City.
Yes, sir. Thank you guys for having me. I appreciate it.
Welcome to the area.
Thank you very much. This is actually my first time in Brighton.
First time in Brighton. What's awesome, too, is because when I walked out to greet you out in the waiting room, I'm like, Did you actually drive down from Traverse City today? He's like, I stayed at my brother's house.
I'm like, he's got to have stayed at his brother's. Yeah, there's no way he's driving 4 hours in the morning.
My brother's side lives in Sterling Heights. So Sterling Heights. 45, 50 minutes away from here, so it was easy.
Where'd you actually grow up?
So I was born in Cadillac, Michigan, which is about 45 minutes south of Traverse City.
Yep.
And I've lived in Traverse City since I was two, and I've been there ever since.
How'd your brother get to Sterling Heights?
So he lived in Traverse City with us when I was really, really young.
Yep.
And then he moved out to Nashville for his job for music and all that good stuff. And then his family brought him back to Michigan, Sterling Heights. Wanted to be closer to us. And
so how often do you come down to this part of town?
You'll ask him, he'll tell you the exact same thing. Not enough.
It's tough, right? You get busy and got life going on and you're crushing it in real estate. It's hard. I mean, it'd be one thing if it was, you know, just across town, but, you know, it's like a
four-hour drive.
It's about three and a half. I have a lead foot, so I'm...
And you can get away with it through most parts of Michigan. I kind of know where most cops sit, you know, and you don't want to get pulled over them.
Yeah.
Just had to pay a ticket recently.
Yeah, you did.
Oh,
she got caught with a phone in her hand at the light, right?
Red light. This is a real thing. Like, they give you a ticket. They look at your car, in your car, if you have a phone in your hand.
Because you can't even have something in your hands even when
you're parked. You can't even lie about it. I'm like, I did have my phone. I mean, you're right.
Prove it.
I know.
Exactly. That's a good one.
Prove it. Show me the photo that you
have. But aren't we now a hands-free state?
We are a hands-free state. You can't even have it in your hands. It's so silly. So it's like you're done.
That's ridiculous.
Yeah.
But no, I think I come down here at least every other month. It used to be pretty much monthly where I'd at least come down for like just a quick like Friday, Saturday, Sunday trip.
Yeah.
Depending on the weather.
Yeah. Work takes over. Life takes over.
Yeah.
You definitely need to come down here a lot more.
Well, we appreciate you making the drive down to be on the show.
I appreciate you guys having me.
Yeah.
You guys are killing it.
Yeah. Well, so are you. And that's why you're here.
I appreciate you.
Speaking of that, you know, we had the opportunity to meet, I think it was, did we meet in 2022?
We met last year at the retreat in Traverse.
2022, right?
That's a Rotary U retreat.
Yep. In the summer.
Yep.
That was my first time, I think, speaking as the keynote. So you heard my...
Killed it.
You saw, matter of fact, did you help us bring the jail out? Were you helping with the props?
Nope, that was not me.
I was trying to remember who it was, and I thought it was you.
I wish it was me. It was not me.
We were bringing out the props. So Eric saw the props on the stage with the little jail cell and the toilet.
Justin's finger almost cut off. Halfway.
It almost did get cut off. We were working on that.
Really?
So we were creating that jailhouse prop the day before.
Okay.
And we had no clue how it was going to come together. And obviously Traverse City
doesn't. Turned out great, by the way.
Thank you. Traverse City doesn't have like a ton of stores. I mean, they've got stores, but how are we going to find a jail cell? Because initially I was calling like prop stores like, hey, you know how like sometimes like they'll set up like a jail with teachers to come in and like go into jail to raise money for.
Sure.
I couldn't find one. So I'm like, we got to make a jail. And so me and a couple of guys like went to, I think there's a Lowe's.
Yes.
And we went to Lowe's to try to figure this out. And I'm like, how are we going to build a jail cell that we're going to take on stage and do all this? So we ended up like getting like some plastic pipes and some this, that, and the other. Well, the night before, I'm like cutting the styrofoam and it literally slipped box cutter on my finger. So if you look at me speaking that day, I have like a red finger. I have like this red tape or band-aid on my, but you were there and we had an opportunity to connect. You came up to me, introduced yourself, and immediately I felt a connection to you. I mean, I meet 100%. A lot of people and, you know, you just sometimes feel like you connect with someone when you talk to them.
Yeah.
And, we connected and then you signed up for the prospecting boot camp.
So you were actually my first teacher in Glover U.
Yeah.
Oh,
wow. Okay.
How did you end up finding out about Glover U and actually coming to the event?
So, I mean, everybody really in Michigan knows about Jeff Glover and his signs, billboards, media, all that good stuff.
Yep.
So I just saw some social media that, you know, he was coming to Traverse City and I'm like, why not? You know, I've always tried to be as much of a sponge as humanly possible, you know, when it comes to learning as much as I can and trying to perfect my craft and always open to learning. And I saw that Jeff was coming and I'm like, why not learn? Why not learn from the best? So
did you come by yourself?
Yes.
Did you come with a couple other agents?
No, just by yourself. I came solo.
I came solo.
And did you come to the half day session initially and then come to the big event? Or did you just come to the big event?
Big event.
Wow.
I went all in. That's awesome. Yep. So I came, I bought my general admin ticket.
Yep.
I think it was after like the initial keynote.
Yeah.
It might have been after yours.
Yeah.
I'm like, I'm going to upgrade to VIP while I'm here. So did that and the rest was history.
That's awesome that you did it then, because now you can't. VIP like sells out before the event starts.
Dude,
it's growing
like
so much.
Like everybody in Glover U is insane. Like as soon as you guys announce, like those tickets get swooped up and hotels get swooped up and it's amazing to see. It's amazing to be a part of.
Yeah, right. And so you came that day and before we get into that, let's back up a little bit. Sure. So how long have you been in real estate?
Okay. So this is year number 7 going into year number 8 for me.
Nice.
Wow.
I love it. I found my passion. I found what I love and I'll be doing real estate as long as I possibly can.
And how long have you, not how long have you been in real estate, but what'd you do before real estate?
So I've only been in food service and real estate.
Okay.
That's all I've ever done. So
now when you say food service, are you talking about like, hospitality, like serving and stuff?
Yep, exactly.
Okay.
So my mom actually got my first job at a local nursing home in Traverse City. So she had been working there for 15 plus years.
Yeah.
Everybody loved her. And I had been volunteering from the time I was like 9 or 10.
Yeah.
Everybody knew me. I didn't have a first name.
It was literally
Kathy's son.
Kathy's son.
Nobody knew my name.
Kathy's son. Kathy's son, come here.
Literally, nobody knew who I was. And I'm like, guys, I have a name. Nope, you're Kathy's son. So I was volunteering there from the time I was like 9 or 10. And it was my first job when I turned 15. Started washing pots and pans and serving food to the elderly and getting really, really close to everybody there. It was so much fun.
That was awesome.
A ton of fun. So
that's awesome.
I worked there probably, I'm going to be off on this, so probably early, mid 20s.
Mm-hmm.
And then I went from there and I started serving at Buffalo Wild Wings.
Nice.
Mm. Yeah.
Justin loves that place. They give him little baby wings.
I get always gypped by Buffalo Wild Wings.
Every time we go, my boys always laugh. They're like, he gets the small, they give him the, like he's a big dude. They give him the smallest little wings.
Like,
you can't control what you're serving. But like they just kind of grab
being,
and go.
Being
right?
down here, I found Art and Jake's.
Art and Jake's.
Art and Jake's is way better than B-Dubs.
Better.
Yeah. Way better. So if your boys are looking for wings, go there.
Well, they love B-Dubs. It's just me. Like we go as a family. Everybody orders the wings and they bring out my plate and I get my little bowl of wings and I'm like, where's the rest of them? I got like little nuggets, like little half nuggets.
No.
And they got the biggest wings. Everybody's like, hey, we love this. Every time.
Okay. I have to ask this.
Yeah.
Flats or drums?
There is
a correct answer.
I love flats.
So yeah.
I don't like drums. So I feel like it's too much gooey.
I like flats too. Yeah. I'd say flats over
flats,
drums.
For sure. And then I'm a ranch guy.
Definitely ranch.
Yeah, yes. Ranch.
So what's your go-to at B-Dubs for your sauce?
Okay. So I haven't been to B-Dubs in so long, but I'm usually a spicy garlic.
That's me.
And a medium buffalo guy.
So here's what I do what are yours, Joy?
Buffalo.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what I do is when I go to Buffalo Wild Wings, I get bone teriyaki.
Bone-in.
And I get bone-in teriyaki. And then I get I get the boneless spicy garlic.
Got it.
And then definitely
spicy garlic is so good.
It's the best.
It's delicious.
It's the best. Yeah.
It's amazing.
I don't know if I've ever had it, actually, but I don't even want to go to Buffalo Wild Wings. We haven't gone in a while. I want to go to this new place he's talking about.
You need to go to Art and Jake's. I don't know if it's a chain. I don't know if it's a local place.
Yeah.
But, and I don't know if you have one anywhere near here, but they have a couple in Sterling Heights.
Art and Jake's.
Oh, okay.
Incredible.
Yeah.
Incredible.
Well, I will say, from a chain standpoint, we've got a new chain, and it's Wingstop.
No,
wait.
Wing Snob.
Wing Snob.
Never been. I've been to Wing Stop, not Wing Snob.
Wing Stop was like, that was pretty good, but Wing Snob.
Okay.
Oh, man. Like, okay. The best. And it's their boneless or their tenders. It's the most juicy.
I love that we go from real estate to food. And
I love this conversation.
Oh,
I can talk
we food. We love food.
Yeah. Ask anyone in my life. Food. I can talk food all day. This is great.
Well, you know what's awesome is, you know, you're a successful real estate agent, but I
appreciate
you. But I love that a lot of people who came from the hospitality industry.
Yeah.
Are great real estate agents.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Because what is real estate? It's a people business.
That's it. Mm-hmm.
And I recently interviewed a real estate agent, and he came from, you know, the people business as well. And it's just like, when you're in the people business, you're going to be successful because you understand that real estate is relationships.
Yeah. You have to be relationship and people focused.
100%.
Because if the client's not happy,
right,
nobody's happy.
Right.
You learn how to juggle, and you learn how to, you know, handle chaos. And
yep.
I think everybody needs to work in food service serving at least once.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then do whatever they end up doing.
100%. Some of the best real estate agents come from the hospitality industry. And so how did you transition from hospitality into real estate? How did that happen?
Yep. So like I said, I was at B-Dubs, ended up managing and going between them and their sister company, Bagger Dave's, and then came back to B-Dubs.
Yep.
And then ended up going back to serving because I found that was way more of my passion than managing was.
Yep.
I just... more people focused and everything.
Yeah,
like
absolutely.
That. One of my regulars who would come every week, but like every other week, every month, whatever, ended up being a local recruiter, real estate recruiter for one of the local brokerages up there. And I didn't know that. And she's like, hey, you know, I recruit, you know, for, I think it was Keller Williams was the place.
Yeah.
And she's like, you'd be amazing. I think you'd be great.
Yeah.
And I'm like, no, I'm really happy with doing what I'm doing. I wanted to open up my own restaurant, and I was really, really committed on that.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. And so she kept coming in. I blew her off for two.
She came in all the time.
Oh, all the time.
That's
all
the
time. She had a big family. Yeah. She top of mind. She was smart. She was very smart.
Yeah.
Shout out Kim. Anyway, so yeah, I blew her off for 2 years, and then I called her one day, and I'm like, I'm ready. Let's do it. So from then I took my test and I failed it 4 times. And
that's okay, because Joy failed it like 7.
I have no shame.
I'm not going to say I came in with that information because I've heard episodes before. Yeah. But so, I mean, you guys know the material itself for the test is really easy.
Yeah.
It's just the way they ask the questions.
Oh, they trick you.
Where your A, B, C, D, they're all like one or two words apart.
Off. Oh, it's ridiculous. Yep.
And so I get through the class and I'm like, oh, I'm going to be great. I know this. I didn't study at all.
Yeah.
Didn't study at all. So failed it the first time, failed it the second time, failed it the third time, failed it the fourth time, hadn't studied once.
Yeah.
And so then my broker at the time for the local brokerage there, she was like, maybe you might want to try and study.
Study.
Just this one
study,
time.
Yeah.
So of course I go back, I study and then I pass.
Yeah.
So
that's awesome.
Yeah.
And so you make the jump in. Did you go part-time to start and try to get your feet wet, or did you go full-time? How'd you do it?
Yep. So at the time that I had my license, I was working at a different restaurant. I had moved on from Buffalo Wild Wings, and I had planned on going part-time, you know, until I established myself, and then I planned on leaving. So I was only going like 1 or 2 days a week at this local restaurant, and I'm like, hey, just let me know what my schedule is. I can do it. No problem.
Yep.
Ended up, you know, with 3 or 4 scheduling conflicts that I'm like, I'm not going to be there. I can't, because I'm never there to check my schedule. And so I ended up having to, that was probably a year or so into having my license. Yep. I had planned on staying there a lot longer.
Yeah.
Because it took me a while to get my first deal. It took me a year.
Yeah.
It took me a year to get my first deal. So I ended up leaving that restaurant and then ended up going full time into real estate.
Yeah.
A heck of a lot shorter period of time than I planned on.
Yeah.
You planned. Wow.
And that's how it normally goes. And I love even, you know, with how you got into real estate, like it wasn't planned, right?
No.
Somebody obviously shows up and starts to recruit you. And what I find is, and everybody we've interviewed and, you know, people come on, like even people you talk to just outside of the podcast is like, Nobody ever really grew up and said, "Hey, I wanted to be a real estate agent when I was a kid. Like that was the thing I wanted to be." Most
never
people,
yeah, once no, crossed my mind at all.
Yeah, like people like fall into real estate, yeah, and mm-hmm, they get in for whatever reason, but yeah, then they see the opportunity and yeah, really take off with it. And that's something that you've done. And so yeah,
I appreciate that.
So you joined, did you join Keller Williams to start?
I did.
You yep did? Okay.
So Keller Williams was
great
my
place to start, by the way.
Totally. 100%. Yep. So I joined them. And at the time, you know, the training was, we were just, you know, reading out of a book,
yep,
doing something along those lines.
Yep.
And I'm a hands-on person.
Yeah.
I want to go out in the field. Yeah. I want to do this stuff. But again, I'm brand new.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
I don't know what I'm doing.
Right.
I don't know what an earnest money deposit is.
Right.
I have no clue.
Right.
So I'm like, you know, this really isn't necessarily for me. I ended up connecting with, you know, two really great agents who were at another brokerage,
yep,
and they're like, "Hey, you should come, you know, join mm-hmm us. We'll mentor, we'll
yeah
be on a team,
yep,
blah, 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 blah."
Yeah.
So fast forward, we ended up leaving that second brokerage mm-hmm and we ended up going to another one.
Yep.
They had a falling out. So
yep
then I had a choice to make, you know,
yep,
I could stay there with one or leave and go with the other.
Yep.
I ended up leaving
yeah
and going with the other. And we formed, you know, a little bit of a team there. We were business partners.
Yeah.
So long story short, I've been to just about every brick and mortar brokerage in Traverse City, but I was always leaving, you know, on good terms.
Yeah.
Like the team that I was on, yeah, I've always been on a team.
Yep.
We just couldn't find our spot.
Yeah.
And then, you know, a handful of years ago, I want to say it was like five or so.
Yeah.
I lost my mom and went through, you know, a really, really, that was probably the lowest point of my life. My, mm-hmm, my mom was my absolute best friend.
Yeah.
And so she beat cancer, three times. It finally got her the fourth. She had a lot of health issues outside of that. So mm-hmm when I lost her, I started, you know, not necessarily just dropping the ball,
right?
If I'm going to be completely yeah honest. Yeah. So yep, like I was losing clients, you know, I had my go-to lender, you know, reach out to my business partner at the time and they were like, "What's going on with Eric?"
Right.
Yeah.
And so we, like my team and I decided to mutually part ways because again, I wasn't, you know, stepping up to the plate. I wasn't doing what I was supposed to do. And I needed that time.
Yeah.
Right.
And I didn't want to, you know, keep them down in there with me. Wanted them to go do their thing, completely yeah respect it.
Yep. Mm.
And so at that point, my team lead and one of my co-managers now on my team, Tommy Corbett,
yeah,
was at our local board doing a like how to build a team type thing and brought a couple other members of the team. And as soon as it was done, I sent him and one of the other people who showed up a little personal note to each of them. Really appreciate, you know, all the information, would love to connect and just stay in touch. Mm. And so after that, they had actually reached out to me and Tommy and BJ, love them, shout out. we ended up having a sit down meeting like, "Hey, you should come to Remax. We would love to have you."
Yeah.
And my response was, "I'll absolutely come, but only if I can join your team."
Yeah.
And they're like, "Oh, you know, we didn't even think that was a possibility."
Right.
And I'm like, "That's the only way I'm coming."
Yeah.
So we had another meeting after that. Loved what they had to say. Loved the culture. Loved, you know, second generation family ran business.
Yeah.
I love that.
Bob, you know, who's at the very top, Bob Ray, yeah, just celebrated his 50th year in real estate.
Wow.
He's forgotten more real estate than I'll ever know in my entire life. Wow. So
50 years. That's amazing.
50 years.
Full of knowledge.
One of the kindest and just best people you'll ever meet in your entire life. I'm so blessed to be surrounded by the people that I am.
That's great.
So after that, it was history.
That's awesome. So how many years ago was that you joined the team?
So this is my third going on my fourth year with the team.
Third year.
Okay. And congrats because you're now a sales coach with them, right?
Yes.
Yep.
Thank you so much. Yep. So awesome. I've been the sales coach over there for the last several months.
Okay.
That's awesome.
That's amazing.
Big shout out to, you know, you, Jeff, Glover, you know, everything that I've learned from you guys and Andy Nelson, you know, my coach.
Your coach, yeah.
Everything that I've learned from that has really translated into that role and being able to pour into everybody that I can. And
I love it because, you know, all I know is Jeff Glover, right?
Yeah.
So when I started in real estate 10 plus years ago, I learned that system before Glover U was a thing. And we've had, you know, quite a few agents here on the show that we've interviewed that have, you know, joined the Glover U family, been a part of the Glover U family. And I always love hearing the before and after, right? Yeah. Like how was business before? How has it been going since? Because The thing that I love about, you know, what we have at Glover U is not only is it a system to follow, but when you surround yourself with other people who are winning, you know, it literally causes you to come up, right?
You have to.
And I've seen, you know, even from the short period of time that I've known you, just under 2 years, you know, I didn't obviously know your business beforehand, but I've seen the success that you've been able to create since coming into the Glover U community.
Yeah.
Talk about that. So you're at the event back in 2022.
Yeah.
What happened after that?
Oh my gosh.
How did you handle him as a coach? I mean, to make these calls.
Like, not to boost his ego a little bit, but Justin was incredible. So again, Justin was one of the first ones that
so
I connected.
Sweet. I for the love, y'all.
I'm only honest. Justin was one of the first like Glover U coaches that I really, you know, connected with. I connected with his keynote, you know, on stage. What was that? A year, two, what?
Almost
what,
two, what? It'll be 2 years in July.
Almost 2 years ago in Traverse City at the retreat.
Yep, the retreat.
And so right after that, I signed up for your prospecting bootcamp.
Yep.
Within, I think, a few weeks after that, I signed up for coaching.
Yep.
And so I just went all in.
You went all in.
And I've been a walking billboard for prospecting bootcamp and Glover U ever since.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So, I mean, prospecting bootcamp, for example,
and you never really prospected before prospecting bootcamp, right? Expireds and FSBOs. Really?
So, and again, like anytime anybody ever hears prospecting, they immediately go cold call, door knock, whatever it is.
Yeah.
And to me, it's just being more proactive rather than reactive when it comes to business generation.
Yep.
It's picking up your phone.
Yep.
You know, it can be cold call. It can be circle prospecting. It can literally just be reaching out to your sphere and engaging in that conversation. It doesn't have to be the terrifying cold call, door knock, whatever. Of course, that's a big key component that still works.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
That's not how I feel about prospecting.
Yeah.
So with the prospecting bootcamp, I 6x'd my investment within 45 days when I closed a FSBO.
Yeah. And how much was that FSBO again? Well, I mean, I know you took an expired, your first listing you took.
We'll get to that. So, I mean, the FSBO itself, I think was 220, 225.
Yeah.
But again, I can think back to the conversation.
Right.
I'm in my office. Shout out Darius, who's really good
love
friend.
Darius.
Darius Norton. Great guy. He's one of my best friends. He's on my team.
Yeah.
Love the dude. So we used to be office mates together. So he would hear my cold calls and everything. And I'm telling you, we were in the office. I'm sitting with the script in front of me, reading it verbatim.
Verbatim.
Just like reading it from the top to bottom,
verbatim.
And I didn't get through the first paragraph talking to Carrie, who ended up being the for sale by owner. Mm-hmm. She cut me off and she's like, "It's so funny you're calling. I want to list my house. I've been wanting to get a realtor over here."
Yeah.
So I got through the rest of the script, went over and talked to her and her parents, everything. They're incredible people.
Yeah.
Listed, closed that. The expired that you were talking about.
Yeah. So, cause I remember when you posted that and you told me that, I'm like,
I didn't hear this.
He's like, "This works."
So this was the very first expired that I had. Shout out to Emily. And she's actually, her and her boyfriend are really good friends of mine.
Oh, I love that. They're clients and not friends.
Incredible people. I love them. Anyway, so cold called Emily, again, with the script right in front of me, read it verbatim.
Yep.
Now, again, I've always been against scripts.
Yeah.
I've been against scripts because I don't want to sound robotic.
Yeah. And that's normal. Most people feel that way. Yeah.
But what I've realized is that it's literally just a roadmap for the conversation because inevitably the prospect will divert you from there.
Yep.
And it's just a guide back to know where to take the conversation.
Yep. Mm.
You're inevitably going to turn it into however you want to turn it into, whatever works for you.
Yep.
It just gives you an idea as to where to take the conversation when it derails.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
So Emily, I cold called her, read the script verbatim.
Yep.
And I,
period.
And like, I'm looking at Darius because he's next to me when I'm having this conversation and like, we're high fiving in the background and I'm like, "Dude, this works. It's crazy."
Yeah.
And so I get to the end, I set the appointment and I was getting ready to head out of town to actually come downstate and see my brother.
Yeah.
So I get a hold of two of my team members, BJ and Betsy Brick.
Yep.
And they're actually brother and sister.
Yep.
And I'm like, "Hey, I need you guys to go on this appointment with me."
Yeah.
It expired at 1.9 million.
Wow.
And I knew it was a little high.
Yeah.
It was a little high.
Yeah.
So they went out there. They killed it.
Yeah.
I reached out to Emily before I came back and I'm like, hey, I just need to come out, talk price. Yeah. I'm going to bring docs, you know, that way we can sign, set the expectation. Yep. She's like, great. Everything sounds great.
Yep.
So we listed that one at 1.6.
Wow. And first expired.
Wow. Was expired at 1.9.
And you weren't calling expireds or FSBOs before prospecting.
No, this was my first expired that I converted. Wow. And like I said, the only other experience that I had was the for sale by owner before.
Wow. Mm.
So we listed it at 1.6. I think we were under contract within 3 or 4 days. We ended up closing at 1.595. And then my very
not bad for my very first one.
Shout out Justin Ford.
Hallelujah.
My second one was in Empire. I don't know if you guys are familiar. It's within. Yep. I think.
I know.
Yeah.
Anyway, gorgeous little town.
Yeah.
And
is that by Glen?
Glen Arbor. I'm horrible with where things are. If I'm
north, south, it's just left, up there right,
somewhere.
It's up there somewhere. Yeah. Anyway, so yeah, this one had been on and off the market with different brokers for 10 years.
Wow.
For 10 years. Couldn't sell for whatever reason. Gorgeous home. Absolutely stunning. Yep. Overlooking the water.
I was going to say.
Great.
Yeah.
So Bob and I actually went into the meeting and he's an older gentleman. He was a banker.
Yeah.
And so Bob brought a ton of value.
Yeah.
And I make the reference every day. Like, I really didn't say anything.
Yeah.
I brought my team lead in. Yep. They ended up knowing each other from like 30 or 40 years ago.
Wow.
Everybody knows Bob. Everybody loves Bob. So I'm sitting there, not really speaking or saying a word whatsoever. Bob's doing all the talking. And then I just take the contract out and I'm like, here's where it is, price, blah, 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 sign. So we listed that one at 1.15. And then I think within 2 months, I think we closed at 985,000.
Wow.
So those were my first two expireds.
First two expireds.
After having no experience with expireds, FSBOs, cold calling or anything.
Wow.
And literally all I did was I read a script verbatim.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah. And what I love about you, Eric, is, you know, when you join the prospecting bootcamp, you know, I always teach, if you follow the process,
just do it.
The process works. Uh-huh. Mm. And you are literally like a poster child, like perfect example of what is possible. And it's not even like you come from a huge market, because Traverse City is a small real estate market.
Traverse City's small.
Yeah. Compared to like where we're at here in the Detroit area.
Yep. Mm.
There's way more people to reach out to. There's way more people to call here.
Yeah.
And I know a lot of times real estate agents say, well, that might work in your area, but I live in a small town area.
Sure.
And you're the perfect example of, it doesn't matter how big or small the area is. It's following what is taught and doing the work. And you did that. And and not only did you do it back then, you've been continuing to do it.
Yeah. So again, to your point, like, there are less opportunities, you know, up there than there are down here.
Yep.
Sure. But that also means that there are less. It's less competition and less people working.
Somebody's going to get that business.
Somebody
might as well be Eric.
Somebody's going to get it. It might as well be me.
Yeah, you need to be Mr. Traverse City. Well, yeah. I mean, like, everybody should know you in Traverse City. Yeah. You know, like, Mr. Traverse City Realtor.
Oh no! So the fact
Joy's labeling you.
The fact that you just made that reference.
Why is it bring back a
just,
memory?
No, just listen. So my oldest brother, his wife, and my family, they have this big joke that they call me Mr. Traverse City.
That's great.
Oh, there it is. There's confirmation.
No.
Why? Why?
No.
Tell me why.
No, and they all want to invest in a billboard. And
I had no idea.
When they hear this episode, they are going to absolutely die.
Listen, what are their names?
Justin and Jen.
That's a good name.
Justin and Jen.
Hey,
I literally had no idea. I just said Mr. Traverse City.
We're backing you guys, Justin and Jen, on this billboard.
Because guess what? When people think of Traverse City, they can think of Eric.
Oh my gosh. Mr. Traverse City. So they got me a stocking stuffer at Christmas, a t-shirt that said Mr. Traverse City.
There it is.
The Lord told me that.
Oh my gosh.
Listen, so.
This is where you got to go.
If you guys could see me, I'm absolutely beat red right now.
They can see you.
Here's the camera. They can see you.
Mr. Traverse City's in the house.
Oh my God. This is not a thing.
Needs to be a thing. So
I feel like
So by the time we drive up to Traverse City this summer for the retreat,
I don't want to see the billboards. No.
I'll
dress up like an elf like Jeff.
It would work. I'm telling you. Have you seen his elf billboards?
I drove by one of them on the way here, and it looks amazing.
Listen, the billboards work. So Mr. Traverse City, we want to see your billboards.
I can't believe
some good marketing right there.
I can't believe I just said that,
and it's like a good marketing for you.
No, I love it.
They're going to think I put a bug in your ear.
No, I had
no idea, honestly.
Yeah.
Give me my $50 after.
Oh, my gosh. Just kidding. 65.
But I'm excited because, you know, I love seeing when real estate agents get it. right? Mm. When they plug into something and they do the work. Because I think a lot of real estate agents, especially now the market has shifted, it's changing.
Yep.
A lot of people are getting out of the business.
So much opportunity. Well,
right now. But there's so much opportunity. And like you said, when you do the work and you show up consistently, you get results. Now, do you get a $1.5 million listing, you know, every time you first start calling? No. Do you get a $1.1 million opportunity and sell it for $900? No, but there are opportunities that are out there, right?
Absolutely.
And you're an example of what is possible if you show up and do the work. And, you know, the one thing for me is, you know, I started the real estate industry prospecting. That's all I know.
Yeah.
So when I teach it, I'm super passionate about it. And speaking of prospecting, you know, one of the things that makes it easy is using systems and processes. And one of the systems that I personally use when it comes to prospecting is Redex. And I want you to hear about it right now. Are you a real estate agent looking to sell more homes this year and make more money but not sure how? The answer is simple. You just need to talk to more people. Being a real estate coach and teaching thousands of real estate agents all over North America and personally selling on average 100 homes per year, the thing top producing real estate agents have in common is that they use systems and technology to get in front of more people and have more conversations about real estate. And the system I use every day to ensure my success in real estate is Redex. Redex is my secret weapon for success in this competitive world of real estate that allows me to take 7 to 10 listings on average every month. Redex provides me with the highest quality homeowner lead data, phone numbers, and industry-leading communication tools to connect with homeowners actively looking to sell, giving you the edge to be the first agent in the door. Redex's triple line power dialer will boost your conversations, connecting you seamlessly with more motivated homeowners ready to sell, allowing you to leave pre-recorded voicemails effortlessly for those that don't answer. But that's not all. Say goodbye to time-consuming neighborhood farming. Redex provides you with phone numbers and addresses for homeowners in your area in seconds, making prospecting a breeze. How about investors and landlords, pre-foreclosures, for sale by owners and expireds? Redex is your all-in-one prospecting solution. Don't miss out on the opportunities waiting for you. Take the first step towards increased production, more listings, and long-term success. Visit sellmorewithredx.com right now to start your prospecting journey with the most accurate contact information on the market. And because you're a listener of my podcast, Redex will waive your $150 setup fee. Go to sellmorewithredx.com and start selling more homes today. And so, you know, Redex, there's a lot of different ways that you can generate business.
Yeah.
We teach that in Prospecting Bootcamp that, you know, you can dial, you can knock,
yep.
You know, you can do the just listed, just sold, you can do circle prospecting.
Yep.
Is prospecting still a part of your business today?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah. So
you just had your best recently. I mean, wasn't last year like your best year?
Yeah. So last year was my best year. This year has been my best year.
Yeah.
Last year I did a little over 9.7. Yeah. This year I did just over 11 million.
Give me some right here, bro.
Wow.
I
appreciate it.
Now, what was your business before Glover U?
So before Glover U, I think my biggest year was like mid to high sevens.
So you went from 7 to 11 in 2 years.
7 to 11 in 2 years, which honestly has been like one of the biggest things that I've learned is eagles want to fly with eagles. Mm. Surround yourself with the best people.
Yeah.
Mm. Like if anybody asks me like what are you doing, whatever it is, that's been my cheat code.
I love
that. Hard work, all of that stuff, you know. Mm. Trying to define my morning routine, you know, win the morning, win the day. Yep. Truly believe
yep.
that.
Yep. Mm.
My honest cheat code has been surrounding yourself with the best people and surrounding yourself with the type of people where you want to be.
Yep.
Yeah.
Like if I want to be like a Justin Ford,
right.
I want to immerse myself as much as I possibly can
yep.
with Justin Ford.
Yep.
You know, in my situation, it's Bob Brick, Tommy Corbett, mm. BJ. Yep. My coach, Andy, you know, yep. Kate Simon, yep. Jeff Glover, like anybody that I want to be like and grow and raise my lid, whether it mm. be leadership or an agent or just, you know, becoming a better person, becoming a better man.
Yep.
I need to surround myself with those, yeah. with those people.
100%. I was on the way to the podcast studio this morning. I was listening to an Ed Mylett episode. I actually mm-hmm. sent it to Joy.
Incredible.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And we saw him, right?
Oh my gosh.
At the last, Summit.
Amazing.
And,
yeah, we were all crying.
Yeah, we were.
Well, I was.
Yeah, I was. Yeah, I was.
But one of the things, you know, that he talked about in the episode is how unless you surround yourself with people who are winning at a high level, you can easily get stagnant
absolutely.
And kind of like just adapt to your environment mm-hmm. or go or you know, be drawn to what's comfortable
yep.
versus being challenged. Mm. And so I think anytime you talk to someone who's creating success or winning or succeeding, it's so important, the community that you're a part of, the people that you surround yourself with.
Yeah.
And honestly, Glover, you, even for us, you know, even though we're coaches, like every time we go to an event, like we go to the next level yeah. because of the people.
I'm actually, when I go, I look for the, sorry, new men, but I'm looking for the woman in that place that's going to challenge me more than what I'm doing.
And 100%.
I want to sit and have a cup of coffee or talk to them on the break. And, yeah. you know, so, because I know there's tons of people doing more or a beast in yeah. you know, in their health or whatever it is. How are yeah. you managing all this and that? And just, yeah. you know, picking their brains. And I think that that's huge, is having that challenge in all parts of our life, not absolutely. Just real estate, but in our physical life and our yeah. spiritual life and all of it. I mean, all of it yeah. plays a role, right? Yeah, and who we are.
See, and what's really inspiring to me when it comes to seeking out other leaders
yep.
is seeing people who have made it to that level, yeah. quote unquote, you yep. know, that mm-hmm. I aspire to, for example,
yeah.
but they continue to raise their lid themselves,
yep. Yep.
you know? So like being like, if you're in a leadership role,
yeah.
you're not going to be able to raise the lid and raise the potential of those under you or around you if you don't continue to raise.
Yes.
So that's definitely been something that I've learned from Glover U as well.
John Maxwell has a book, I think it's called The Five Levels of Leadership.
Yep.
You know, and he talks about how, yeah, unless you're, you know, if you're a level two leader, you can't lead someone who's at level three because yeah. they're above you. You gotta continuously raise that level
yeah.
so that you can be that and teach that to other people, which yeah. is so huge.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah. So, you know, you've been dominating, you've been doing some great things, you know, you've been creating success. And again, in a market that's not like this big metropolitan, huge city area.
Sure.
Even in a market like this, right, where things yeah. have changed, things are starting to slow down.
Yep.
You know, people are getting out of the business. You know, for the person that's listening right now, right, the Eric of 3 years ago.
Sure.
You know, who's mm-hmm. really in the business, making some things happen, but really kind of trying to find that next level or yeah. even the agent that's just holding on for dear life, like, yeah. how am I going to make it? I mean, what would you say to that agent?
Honestly, it's get a mentor, get a coach.
Yeah.
Surround yourself with the people and learn from the people that you want to be like, you know, whether it be personally or professionally.
Yeah.
Again, mm. that's been my cheat code. Like in the beginning, I had a handful of mentors.
Yeah.
Now I'm on a team full of people who kill it
yeah.
and inspire me every single day, you yeah, know, and that's like other members of management, you know, that's all of the agents on our team. That's our rockstar admin staff. Like yeah. I'm surrounded by people who are continually learning, honing their craft,
yep.
absolutely killing it. So
yep.
I don't have a choice other than, you know, staying on their level or yep. they're going to kick me the heck out of the way.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So again, mm-hmm. I would say get a mentor,
yeah.
get a coach
yep.
to hold you accountable mm-hmm. to your goals yep. and what you say you want to do
yeah.
and take the time to hone your skills
yeah.
and hone your craft.
Yeah.
Those would be the things that I would say.
I love that. That's solid.
It's good.
How can someone get a hold of you? Right. Cause obviously Traverse City, you know, even for second homes is, yeah. like there's so many people, even wealthy people, successful people, famous people. Like Traverse City is a place. So if you've never heard of Traverse City and you're listening to the show,
you know who lives in Traverse City? Actually, I found out my cousin moved out there. Tim Allen. Remember Tim Allen from yes. Home Improvement?
Yes.
So even he's got a place in Traverse City. I don't know if he's there full time, yep. but he comes into my cousin's practice yeah. to get his skin done and all that.
Yep.
We saw Tim Allen at our coach's dinner at one of the spots in Traverse City.
Did you really?
A couple years ago.
He was oh, just really? Okay, there. Then yeah. I think maybe he's there full time.
Where'd you go? What restaurant are you at?
I don't remember what it was called. Bay Shore, something. It was over there right off the water. It was
okay.
beautiful.
Okay.
Yeah, it was a couple of years ago. And
it's
it was
amazing.
Traverse City is amazing. But if somebody has a client that they want to refer or, yep. you know, somebody's looking to buy in Traverse City, how can anybody get a hold of you?
Absolutely. So I'm on Facebook and Instagram primarily. You can just look up, you know, my first and last name, Eric Levanduski. You can call or text me 231-342-1755. I'm always available. If you have any questions or if I can help you or anything you need, I'm always here. So,
yeah. Or even a real estate agent in the Northern Michigan area that's looking for a team. That's looking to, are you guys looking for team members?
Absolutely. No, we're always, you know, scouting for the right person.
The right
you
person. Know, yeah.
This, that like, since I've joined the team, this has been the best culture that we've had. We have such an amazing team.
Yeah.
You know, we have 10 full-time agents. We have 6 admin. So we're always looking for the right person. Yeah. And if you're the right fit, we definitely love to have a conversation.
Yeah. So again, give them that number one more time.
Yep. So my phone, my direct phone number is 231-342-1755.
Yeah. You're crushing it, man. I
appreciate you, brother.
You know, to be able to see someone, especially that has gone through the prospecting boot camp and is actually doing it, it makes me feel good, you know, because, you know, there's a lot of people who sign up for prospecting bootcamp that just don't do the work. That's in life in general, right?
Sure.
There's gonna be a lot of people who, you know, sign up for gym memberships that never actually go work out. Yeah. It's not the gym's fault that, you know, they didn't lose weight. Just like it's, you
they're
know,
gonna collect that money.
They'll blame the gym though.
Right.
They'll
blame but you know, I love seeing people win and I love seeing people succeed, man. And I just want you to know I'm proud of you, man.
I appreciate that. The one thing that I've all of us realtors, we know what it's going to take to be successful.
Yeah.
We all know. There's no shiny nugget. Right. I don't care what your split
no
is.
No secret sauce.
Don't get me wrong. Teams are awesome. I don't care what team you're on. Right. I don't care where you hang your license.
Absolutely.
If you don't do the work, you're not going to be successful. So if your business isn't where you want it to be, I'm very black and white when it comes to this. You're not talking to enough people.
Yeah.
Simply.
Period.
It's picking up the phone and doing what, I mean, circle prospect, cold call, whatever it is, you know, leaning into your sphere. Yep. We all know what it takes to be successful. And it's just talking to more people, making yourself uncomfortable, and just doing the things and taking care of your people. That's it.
And you're doing a great job of that.
I appreciate you so much, brother.
Dude, thank you so much for coming on the show.
Thank you guys for having me. This actually wasn't that bad.
No, it wasn't.
It wasn't bad at all.
Eric was pretty nervous before the show.
Oh my gosh.
But I said, you know what? It's going
to
be good.
I was not looking forward to this whatsoever. I love Justin and Joy and they do such an incredible job, but I was terrified, but I feel
real.
Good. So
yeah, just being
real.
Yeah.
Honestly, you did phenomenal.
I appreciate you, brother.
Yes, sir.
I appreciate you. Thank you guys for the opportunity. Yeah.
Appreciate you, man. Keep up the good work.
Hey, yes, I appreciate it.
Guys, super excited again for another episode here. If you're looking to relocate, you have a client, you're looking for a second home in the Traverse City area, definitely reach out to Eric. If you're a real estate agent in the area and you're looking to join a great team with a great sales manager,
I appreciate you.
Definitely reach out to Eric. Again, this has been another great episode. If you haven't subscribed yet to the podcast, go ahead and hit the subscribe button on your favorite podcast platform. You can also follow us here on YouTube. And if you haven't followed Joy and I yet on social media, you can. You can find us under the Real, Raw, and Uncut brand. We've got a lot of great things that we're going to be launching under the Real, Raw, and Uncut brand here in 2024. You can also follow us at the Justin Ford Podcast. And I do want to remind you that this episode is brought to you by our friends over at Next Door Lending. Next Door Lending isn't just the sponsor of the show. This is our lender. This is where all of our buyers are referred to. We trust Next Door Lending with our buyers, and they do a phenomenal job. Over 600 five-star reviews, a perfect A+ Better Business Bureau rating. And guys, if you are looking to purchase a home here in 2024, call our friends over at Next Door Lending. If you're looking to refinance your home here in 2024, call our friends over at Next Door Lending. And if you are a real estate agent looking for a great mortgage lender to partner with, call my friends over at Next Door Lending today at 888-885-3667 or visit their website at nextdoorlending.com. Thanks for tuning in to another episode. Two things we always love to leave you with. Number one, it's not how you start. What matters is how you finish. And number two, with God, all things are possible. God bless you guys. Thanks for tuning in and we'll see you on the next one.